pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, everyone to his own city. So Jesus went up from Galilee, out of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house of David. He took with him Mary, his espoused wife, who was expecting a child. And it happened that, while they were in Bethlehem, the time came for the baby to be born. Mary gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And the angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shined upon them. The angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. You will find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem to see the newborn king." And they came quickly and found Joseph and Mary and the baby lying in the manger. When they had seen it, they spread the news of what they had seen and what was told to them about the child. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God, but Mary kept all of these things and pondered them in her heart. It must have been difficult for her to comprehend that the beautiful baby sleeping in her arms was the Savior of the world. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem, three wise men came from the east to Jerusalem to ask, "Where is he that is born King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and we have traveled far to worship him." Herod, the king, gathered all the chief priests and scribes, demanding that they tell him where the Christ was to be born. They told him that the prophet said long ago that the child would be born in Bethlehem. The wise men left, and the star went before them to the place where the baby was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with great joy. They saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. They gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And being warned by God in a dream, they departed to their own country another way. Today, we can only imagine the joy of witnessing the angels announcing the birth of our Lord Jesus, or the excitement of rushing to the stable to see the newborn king, or the honor of bringing our gifts to lay at his feet. Each year we are reminded of the miracle of that night so long ago. Let us carry the joy and excitement of this story with us.
Oh. invited down to the fellowship hall for snacks and the tasting part of the tasting party. And I will close with prayer. And then once you go find your parents, okay? After I pray. Shall we pray together? Everybody fold your hands. Not close your eyes. Dear Jesus, thank you for this wonderful story that is so true and it makes a difference today. Thank you for retelling it one more time. Bless us with your peace and presence.